don't miss any content, don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
May 9th, 2001. I was a young man watching my favorite program on TV, martial arts, and all I could hear in the end was breaking news: a stadium disaster has happened at the Accra Sports Stadium. Today, I'll be talking about that fateful night when 126 football fans, teaming football fans, lost their lives at the Accra Sports Stadium after a clash between Kumasi Asante Kotoko and Accra Heart of Oak. As usual, if you're new to the channel, I advise you to subscribe to the channel and to click on the notification bell to get more updates. So, May 9th, 2001, a day that will go down in history as a horrific day for Ghana football. Football fans teamed to the Accra Sports Stadium and 127 initially of them did not come back. One person, however, survived in the end. He was in the mortuary, Abdul Mohammed. He had passed out because of the tear gas, and fortunately for him, he was in line to be put in the morgue. Someone stepped on his foot and he came back to life and was removed from the 127, making it 126 lives that were lost. It was a game, Ghana Premier League game, between Kumasi Asante Kotoko and Accra Heart of Oak. Accra Heart of Oak had won the game 2-1, but fans in the stadium could not accept that result. They did not like that result and started throwing some bottles and other stuff onto the pitch at the referee, targeted at the referee. The police on the day did not do their best, unfortunately. They threw tear gas and rubber bullets into the stands, and fans were looking for ways to escape from the stadium. The stadium doors were shut at that time, and there was no way for them to escape. And unfortunately, a lot of them died not from the tear gas but from asphyxiation. There was a stampede that was caused at the entrance, and the stadium at that time was not built to FIFA standards. It was quite unfortunate, and it was one of the most horrific accidents ever to happen in the history of Ghana football, possibly around the world. It was really something horrific. A lot of families were adversely affected. So many bodies were lying in the morgue of the 37 military hospital, and so many hospitals that were in the area, in Ridge and also at Kolebu Teaching Hospital. May 9th will go down as a time when Ghanaians unfortunately could not be of best behavior, and when the police, who were supposed to maintain orderliness at the stadium, did not take the right decision. Now, this Ghana's two most successful sides taking on each other is always cause of for frenzy, but this time the frenzy went over the board and killed a lot of fans. We learned that our football stadium was not in the best conditions and that we needed to redesign the stadium. After the incident, this was done by the government, and after so many delays in making the stadium to meet FIFA standards, it was officially done. It's quite unfortunate that lives had to be lost before that realization came, and I think May 9th, 2001, whoever or wherever you are, it is a moment of solidarity, a moment of sadness for everyone involved in this beautiful games. Why should fans who go to the stadium to watch a game risk losing their lives? Since that incident, the GFA today has released a statement in commemoration of the 19 years of May 9, 2001. And since that incident on May 9, 2001, no game has been played at the Accra Sports Stadium in the night before, until recently when Kumasi Asante Kotoko took on Legon Cities for the first time in 2020. Kotoko versus Legon Cities was the first time a game was played at night at the Accra Sports Stadium. May 9th, 2001, a moment of condolence to every family that lost a member of their family. So many fathers were lost, so many sons were lost, so many daughters were lost, and so many mothers as well. It's quite unfortunate that we could not get those people to safety when they were looking for a way out. The stampede was the main cause of death. Now, an official inquiry banned police for overreacting with reckless behavior and indiscriminate firing of plastic bullets and tear gas. It also accused some officers of dishonesty and indefensible laxity. Six police officers were charged with 127 counts of manslaughter. The court ruled that the policemen had failed to take a case, to make a case, and that the asphyxiation may have been caused by the stampede and not the tear gas. The Commission of Inquiry recommended improvements in the stadium security and first aid facilities, and that nationwide rapid response teams should be set up. The Accra Sports Stadium was renovated in 2007 according to the FIFA standards. Politics may have deferred the National Sports Council attention to the stadium, and 15 years later, it's again in despair. Accra Sports Stadium has really gone through some renovation works, a lot of entrances in the stadium now, and I think we are moving in the right direction. Following the events, the president at the time, John Ajeku Nkukuo, called for 3 days of mourning. The Ghana Premier League suspended play for a month. Since 2001, corporations and philanthropists, including former Asante Kotoko chairman from 1999 to 2003, Herbert Mensah, have memorialized their tragedy with a fund, the Stadium Disaster Fund, and a series of events in Kumasi. All these to remember those who lost their lives on that fateful night on May 9th, 2001. We'll read a statement from the Ghana Football Association commemorating the May 9, 2001, 19 years on. Now, the statement reads, "Today marks the 19th anniversary of the May 9 stadium disaster, and the Football Association wishes to express its profound condolences to the families and friends of the victims. Today is a day of grief as we again remember the incident that claimed the lives of 127 football fans at the Accra Sports Stadium. Following a stampede during a Ghana Premier League match between Heart of Oak and Kotoko in 2001. As we mark the 19th anniversary of the disaster, we remember our fallen friends, heroes, the colleagues and comrades who lost their lives in that manner while supporting the game they truly love. The GFA remains committed to honor the memory of fallen friends by continuing our efforts to steadfastly improve safety and standards at our match venues. The GFA wishes to appeal to all football administrators, security officers, medicals, and indeed football-loving Ghanaians to cooperate with the Federation and other stakeholders to ensure we don't experience such incidents in our game. Again, we call on clubs to continue educating their fans on the laws of the game and remain law-abiding before, during, and after league matches. Let us constantly remind ourselves that never again should such a tragedy befall our beautiful game and our beloved nation. May the souls of our departed football enthusiasts rest in perfect peace." And I'll echo the thoughts of the Ghana Football Association there. Never again should this ever happen. I later realized that incident happened close to the end of the game, and most of the medical staff and officials had left the stadium at the time. Some fans had already left the stadium at the time as well and were spared their lives. For the 126 that lost their lives, we say condolences to their families. Rest well 19 years on, and we hope that this never ever happens again. What are your memories of May 9th, 2001? Were you there on May 9th, 2001? What do you remember most about that? Where were you when the news broke about May 9th, 2001? Let me know your thoughts in the comments box. I'll see you guys in the next one. Enjoy your day.